Welcome to Dueling Podcast number 105. I'm Mike Girvin from Excel is Fun, and Bill, Mr. Excel Jelen, will be along in a few moments. Hey, this week we have a data dump we get, and it's a report. Data dump every month, and we have these groups, red, and there's two people there, amber, and there's three people here, and green, and there's five people there, and we need to count between. So over on a different sheet, I need to count how many people are in the red group, how many people in the amber. Now, I could create a formula with sheet reference and work back and forth, but I'm going to cheat here. This is a great trick. I'm going to copy this little template and paste it over here. Build my formulas here, and then when I cut and paste at the end, it will create the sheet references on this sheet. All right, now, so count between. So for red, we need to count between red and amber. For amber, we need to count between amber and green. But when we get down here to green, we need to count just everything below green. Now, a couple things here. Sometimes we might have nobody in a particular group, or we might have lots of people. In addition, we have just three groups here. You could have many more, and then you just list them here. Now, I'm going to treat this as a lookup. And I'm going to look up red and amber and help and use that information to help create a dynamic range to then count non-empty cells. I'm going to use the index function and the match function to, in essence, look up a position. All right, so the array, I have no idea how big each month's list will be, so I'm going to select the whole column. And I'm going to use the match function. I'm going to look up red. Red within column A. Comma and 0 for exact match because the information is not sorted. Now, right now, if I highlight this and hit the F9, it gives me 18, which is perfect. It's the 18th row, Control Z. If I highlight the whole index. Now, I want to look up a cell reference and create a dynamic range. But watch this. If I hit the F9 key, index is programmed to retrieve a value, so it's retrieving red, Control Z. I'm going to copy this, and I'm going to put the index function in the context of a range or cell range. Notice A colon A, or if we had over here D3 colon D20, the colon is the context which says I am a range of cells. So I'm going to type a colon, Control V to paste that index. And for the second index, I don't want to look up red. I want to look up amber. Now, this index right here, like the first one, if I hit F9, is returning amber, Control Z. But if I highlight the whole thing, including that colon, and hit F9, boom, it's returning a range. And when I copy this formula down, it'll move from red to amber to green. So Control Z. Now I want to count non-empty cells. So I'm just going to use count non-empty cells. Close parentheses, Control Enter, and copy it down. Now that's not quite what we want, and also we have a problem here. But we always are counting what? Red, Mickey Mouse, amber. So I'm always going to subtract 2 to get rid of the bookends in essence, right? There's red and amber bookends here. When we copy it down, it'll be amber and green. All right, so that's looking good for 2 and 3. If we were to right-click here and delete, you could see it's picking up a 0 because there's nothing in the red group, Control Z. Now here, and I don't have a real good method to fix this, the problem is up between red and amber, we have two bookends, right? Amber and green, two bookends. But here we don't have a second bookend. Now watch this. Here's a great cheat. If I could come down to the end, each month I get this report and just type last, and then have in my template the word last, it would get it right, right? But perhaps I don't. So this is going to get messy here. Well, what's causing the problem, that blank there? So this is delivering a position which doesn't exist. So I'm going to change this. I'm going to say if that relative position there equals double quote, which is just saying, is that cell empty? Then what do I want? Well, what is match delivering? It's delivering a row number. So I'm just going to put some big row number. The most people that will ever be there is 1,000. So I'm going to put 5,000. So that's the value of true, meaning that cell is blank. Otherwise, just run that. Now, this still won't quite work. because what is happening? Up here, we're subtracting 2 because we have red and amber, 2 bookmarks. Down here, it's subtracting 2 and we don't have 2 bookmarks. Again, I don't have a real good solution for this. So at the end, I need to subtract some number, either 1 or 2. So I'm going to say if this equals double quote, that means it's blank, then I want to subtract 1, right? Because green doesn't have another value down here, so I just subtract 1, comma, otherwise 2. Ooh, I'm not so sure. I think that's the best way. Hopefully someone knows a better way to do this. I'm sure Mr. Excel will show us a better way. But there it is. And now I want to cut and paste this over here. Just be careful. That cell reference is looking right there. So be sure and cut that. Control X. Control V, and there we have it. Now, next month, if we get a report like this copy, and I paste it right here, including all those stuff at the top, I should get 00 and maybe 7. So 007. All right, throw it over to Mr. Excel. I hope you have a better way.
Hey, all right, Mike, that's a cool formula. I love your cut and paste to keep the to create the worksheet name references. That was brilliant. I, of course, switched right over to VBA on this and set up some counters for red, amber, green, and figure out that we're going to go from the first row down to whatever the last row is. My famous line of code there to figure out the last row. And I'm looking for things up in the header. If I see the date, then I save the date. And if I'm looking for, if I find red, amber, green, I set that color. And then there was a whole bunch of stuff that I had to ignore, right? So if we hadn't found the first color, don't count anything. There was a note in one of the sheets, a few other things in the sheets that we had to ignore. But then here's where the good stuff happens. Once we know that we have a non-blank cell that I'm going to presume is a patient, and we're down in the color section, then I look at the current color and add one to either red count, amber count, green count, or I created one called problem count, just in case there was ever a day where I got something I didn't expect, and then report this back on a worksheet called report. We'll report the date, the red, the amber, the green, and the problem. All right, so this is has a loop in it, so it'll go through all of the sheets in the workbook. We just have to press Control-Shift-C. Bam. And so there, for each of the worksheets, I get the date and the number of colors. Let's just check. So here on the second sheet, we should have no red, no amber, and 7 green. No red, no amber, and 7 green. So that works. I even think that this will handle the case where there is the amber is missing altogether. Let's I try that. So Control-Shift-C. Yeah, it doesn't get fooled by that. Now, if someone adds a new color in purple, then of course the macro is going to have to be rewritten. Well, hey, I want to thank everyone for stopping by. We'll see you next week for another Dueling Excel podcast from Mr. Excel, and Excel is fun.